for anion, the size should be bigger. Bigger the size, it would be more unstable, because obviously if the size is bigger, the electrons would be scattered everywhere, so it would be easier for the cation to attract the electron cloud towards itself. And if the size is smaller, the electrons are more concentrated at the center, so obviously it will be difficult for the cation, the positive charge of the cation, to pull them out from the center. Whereas when the size is bigger, the electrons are scattered, as I say, so they easily get attracted, and hence they get deformed, as they are very, very far away from the center of the nucleus, right? So for anion, for it being polarized, for it to get polarized easily, the size should be bigger. So so reason I already told you, that if the size is smaller, nucleus can hold everything together, but if the size is bigger, nucleus can't hold them so strongly because they are far away from them. Therefore, greater the size of the anion, greater will be the covalent character. Coming to the charge, this one has got one charge, this one one minus one, and this one has got three charges, three minus. So greater the charge, in this case more will be the covalent character. Obviously, if there are more number of electrons, it will be attracted more, isn't it? So the anion which will have more electrons will be running away, isn't it? And hence more easily it will get polarized. Therefore, for covalent character to be stronger, cation should have a very high polarizing power, and the anion should get polarized. Anion is the one which is getting polarized. So anion should anion undergoes polarization basically. So these two things you should keep in mind. And the size, let's do a recap. The size of the cation should be smaller and the charge should be higher. And again, I discuss the PNGC, pseudo noble gas configuration. These six elements will have excessively high covalent character. I explained you because of the electronic configuration NS2, NP6 and ND10, which are Cu plus, Ag plus, Au plus and Zn2 plus, Cd2 plus, Ag2 plus. And size of the anion should be higher, like bigger. And charge should also be bigger. So the one point of similarity which we could see in both the cases of cation and anions, the charges should be higher. If these conditions are fulfilled, the covalent character would be much, much greater. So let us have a look at few examples. So which compound will have more covalent character? We have lithium chloride, sodium chloride, barium chloride, rubidium chloride. So we know in the periodic table, first we have lithium, then sodium, then potassium, then rubidium. Okay, so obviously as we go down the group, the size of the atom increases. All right, so over here if you see, the anions are all same. So obviously the polarizing power or the covalent character, the compound of the severity or of the covalent character would be due to the cations, not anions, because anions are all same in the given compounds. But as I told you, for the covalent character to be more or the polarizing power to be more, the size of the cation should be smaller. So obviously lithium has got the smallest size, and hence this should be the order. Lithium chloride will have more covalent character, then sodium chloride, then potassium chloride, and then rubidium chloride. Again, let's have a look at this example as well. If you see, the charges are all same. Okay. Even obviously barium chloride, magnesium chloride, then calcium chloride, they all, like beryllium has got 2+, magnesium has got 2+, calcium has got 2+. So same charge, even the cations are same. So we need to see the size. Again, in the periodic table, they all belong to group 2. As we go down the group, the size increases. Hence, this one, which means this one will have more polarizing power and hence more covalent character. And then would come magnesium chloride. And in the last, we have calcium chloride. Okay, because this has got